Hello everybody, my name is Phaethadas. Welcome to this video, to this channel, if this is the first time ever you are here. This is one more build idea that I have to show you. It is a thematic build, and as you have already probably seen in the title of the video. This is the Odysseus build, you know, the well-known hero from Greek history. This is a thematic build, and I put together this build because in the game we have some items named after Odysseus. For example, we have the helm of Odysseus, and we have the Odysseus' armor. We have these items, and I thought let's put together a build which will be using these items, and it will be a thematic build around Odysseus. But it is not just these two items. We have some other items as well that do not have the name of Odysseus on, but they have other names that are names that belong to stories that have to do with Odysseus. For example, Priam's Gate. You know, the story of Troy, war between Troy and Greek world, and all of these things. And Odysseus was there as well. And Achilles, and all of these things, and the Trojan Horse, Priam's Gate. And we also have this club, which is the Polyphemus Tenderizer. It is the master infrequent club weapon that drops only from Polyphemus the Cyclops himself. And those who know the stories of Odysseus at his travels, then they should probably remember the Cyclops Polyphemus and the part he plays in those stories. And here we have this Master Infrequent item, which is very, very rare to drop, and it is even rarer to get it with two affixes and very good ones. Unfortunately, this one has no prefix, it has only a suffix, but fortunately, the suffix is very good, it is good enough at least. It is of Reckless Power suffix, which provides attack speed, strength, points, and, but also minus health regen per second. But it also provides a percentage of physical damage, and I think attack damage converted to health, if I remember correctly. I decided to put all of these items together and make this thematic build. But before we talk about the items more, let's take a look at the skills. I decided to go with Dream and Rune Masteries. And here we have maxed out the Trance of Wrath. This is very good. And, it reduces the resistances of enemies, all resistances. And, you know, it is very powerful. And this is a close combat build, so it is a melee build. And this one always hits the enemies, unless some enemies will spell break this one, and you will have to trigger it again. And it is very, very, very good. It helps very much dealing lots of damage. And also the skill disruption means that enemies cannot use their very powerful spells on you, so it helps with your survivability. We have maxed out these things. Here, this one for the physical damage buff, defensive offensive, total speed and whatnot. We have maxed out the Phantom Strike at the Dream Stealer. This is now an AoE attack, which is very powerful. It hits up to 8 targets. And it deals lots of damage. We have maxed out the Distortion Field because it provides survivability. And we have spent only 1 point here, Distort Reality. But it went up to 6 instantly, with 1 point only, 6 levels, because we use items that provide more levels to skills. In Rune Mastery, we have the Rune Weapon maxed out at on +3. This one charges up and it provides more damage output. This one, Magical Charge, provides elemental damage to our weapon attacks. Elemental Retaliation is every time melee attacking enemies hit you or they try to hit you, they receive back this elemental damage as retaliation. It works only with melee attacks, not with other types of attacks. And I have spent only 1 point here to get the attack damage converted to health stat. If you spend more points here, the 4% attack damage converted to health will not go up. It is a fixed number. I have spent only 1 point here and here, just to have these things in case I will need them. You know, if your health drops below 40%, this one can keep you alive, it can help with survivability, this one as well. This is maxed out because we need offensive ability and whatnot. This is maxed out because we need all of the stats, especially bleed, vitality, resistances. This is maxed out. This is good, sometimes when it triggers it deals added damage, so we kill enemies faster. This is not maxed out yet, but I will max it out in the future. This also works with melee attacks, and with melee attacks it applies damage on enemies. And also in the description, you can check out the description, it says makes your strikes explode with intense heat, comma, add projectiles break into burning fragments. This description is very clear, and it says that end projectiles. If this was working only with projectiles, it wouldn't say add projectiles, it would say only makes your projectiles explode with intense heat and break into burning fragments. So it is very clear for those who are wondering. It works also with melee attacks. It doesn't release any fragments with melee attacks, it only hits multiple enemies. We have maxed out the Thunder Strike, which is very powerful. It is on plus 3. I will max out the add-on later. And here I haven't maxed out this one, but I have maxed out this one because this one provides... it deals reduced armor to enemies and reduced resistances, which is all types of resistances, primary resistances, physical damage, elemental, poison, everything. And if you hit this, your enemies with this one, you will reduce the resistances by a very big amount. And since this stat here is an absolute reduction to resistances, it is a flat one, it stacks with this one here, which is a multiplicative one. So, you will apply this one, for example, on enemies, and the enemies will be hit by this one, or they will be hit by this one, and you will apply this one. You will reduce the resistances by a very big amount, and then you will deal much more damage to them, especially against bosses, this would work wonders. It would be very awesome. So, these are the skills of the build. Now, for the items, as we said before, this is about... before the items, let's go to attribute points. For attribute points, I haven't spent any points on health, I haven't spent points on energy, I haven't spent points on intelligence, I have spent many points on strength, but mostly I have spent points on dexterity. Why? Because with dexterity I wanted to increase my offensive and defensive abilities, mostly my offensive. Because this combination of items doesn't provide that much offensive ability, and I wanted to have even more. And I had to spend on dexterity. And now for the items, we have the Glory Bringer artifact. This artifact also fits perfectly to the theme of the build, because Odysseus is a Glory Bringer guy, type of guy, because he brought glory to Greeks during the Trojan War, because of the Trojan horse, it was his idea. And this is how Greeks got... they passed the walls and they got into Troy and they won the war anyway. But it also helps very much with the stats it provides. It is very good. Here we have Odysseus armor. Of course, this item is perfect for this build because of the theme of the build. But this item unfortunately doesn't provide any resistances. But it provides other very, very nice stats. We have the Helm of Odysseus. Again, this item doesn't provide any resistances, only physical resistance, some other stats, but it has this chance for life leech and energy leech retaliation, which can help very much, but still I would like to see some resistances of this item. Anyway, this is the only item I have upgraded from all these legendary items here. This is the only upgraded one. And it is upgraded with the epic upgrade, not legendary upgrade. And the upgrade provided plus 26 dexterity points and minus 30% reduction to requirements. Here we have the Priam's Gate, not upgraded. It provides many resistances. It is perfect for the theme of the build. We have the Gauntlets of the Necrolord, one of the best gauntlets in the game. Plus one to the skills. We have the Discs of Many, one of the best boots in the game. This also came with Ragnarok. And it provides a bonus to pets, but we don't have any bonus. We don't play with any pets. And here we have the Torque of the Ancestors, Ragnarok item, very powerful. And this one is not upgraded as well. Plus 31% total damage, many, many resistances, thankfully. Because the resistances of this build are not the best. And here we have the Hell Loop of Immortality. I wanted to get strength points and health points with this one, and also I wanted to get the Star of the Evening to give me more attack speed, more elemental damages and whatnot, casting speed as well. And here we have the Hell Jewel of the Tinkerer. Again, Star of the evening, star of the evening, for attacking speed and casting speed and elemental damages. This build deals lots of elemental damage. We have it, of course, to spend more points to intelligence, no points to intelligence at all. But, you know, with rune weapon, this one increases our intelligence by 130% when we get it up to 13 charge levels. And also it increases elemental damages. And also total damage, it is very powerful, and even though this number of intelligence is not very high, it gets increased, and it helps with all the rest of the buffs of this skill, rune weapon. It helps very much with dealing more damage to enemies. Elemental and vitality damage. But mostly elemental, because intelligence also increases vitality damage. And here we have again Polyphemus Tenderizer. As we said before, this one doesn't have a prefix, but it has the suffix of Reckless Power. And I decided to go with Incarnation of Prometheus Flame, first of all because it provides some burn damage over time, which is a fire over time damage, and it helps deal more elemental damage and more damage overall, and it has the relic bonus 35% attack speed. This was very important. It was very important to get attack speed on this build, because the club weapon is a slow weapon, as we can see, speed slow. And it is a melee build, and the build is all about attacking with this weapon. To kill all of our enemies and also bosses with Polyphemus' weapon. The club of Polyphemus, the Cyclops. So, when it comes to the weapon, maybe you could say that this build is also a Cyclops build. Polyphemus, legendary Cyclops. And now our attack speed is great. 189% with a slow club. This is a great attacking speed. But as I said before, let's activate Rune of Life. I have also this skill activated, but it doesn't provide any resistances. These are my resistances in Legendary. Almost perfect, perfect, perfect. Very good, especially in combination with this one, which is very good as well. The head is not perfect, but we have this one added, so it is very, very good. Good enough, Pierce Resistance. But when it comes to Elemental, bad, super bad, Superman bad. Odysseus was not smart enough to get some Elemental resistances, you could say. I haven't upgraded these items. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is upgraded with Epic only. And the upgrade is not good enough. So, if in the future I go ahead and I upgrade all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, plus 1-6 items with legendary tier upgrades, and luckily, hopefully, if I get some elemental resistances on these items, then the build will be fixed and it will be okay. Secondary resistances, stun resistance perfect, slow down very good, energy resistance okay, sleep resistance okay, skill disruption, resistance very nice. Okay, my secondary resistances are very good overall. These are the numbers of damage, but the numbers of damage go up during combat because with rune weapon they get increased. So, this is the build. Let's go kill a couple of enemies so that you can see some gameplay now. Oh! A trapper spear. Monster and frequent spear. So we can see that the numbers of damage go up the more you attack with rune weapon. And also we can see that we attack very fast. This goes Phantom Strike. Also attacking very, very fast with this weapon is very good because for this stat, 7% of attack damage is converted to health and 4% of attack damage converted to health. So you have 11% of attack damage converted to health. Do I have any other source? I don't think I have. No. 11% of attack damage converted to health is a very good amount, especially when you deal good amounts of damage. Thunder Strike. Stun them. Hit them, kill them, see them out of this world. This is the Seal of Fate. It also stuns enemies. Sometimes we see the animation of the Rune World Explode, this one. Rune World Explode has its own animation when it triggers. It is a passive skill, but it has an animation. Anybody else here? No. So we can see that the build is powerful, it is really powerful. Although it doesn't have any, you know, very impressive numbers of damage, but it is still powerful. The only problem is the elemental resistances of the build. By the way, we can see that this character is level 65. This is an older build of mine, which I created some months ago, before the new expansion came out, Eternal Embers. And I created this character with my own accomplished hero method. Oh, a legendary, Pan's Headdress. If you go to check out that method, accomplished hero method of mine, how I make it work, how it works, and why I make it, I created this accomplished hero method back in the day. I have already created a video, which is called Titan Quest, its huge amount of content is a problem and how I solve it. I think this is the title of the video. And in that video, I talk about Titan Quest, about the content, about how awesome the game is, and about the replayability of the game. And also, I showcase the tools I used back in the day to create this accomplished hero method of mine. So, if you want to know how I did it, then you can go and watch that video and see details. So, now, let's defeat the boar. We can see that the build is pretty quick. We have a very good movement speed as well. Very good movement speed, very good attacking speed, very good casting speed. ...4000 DPS when you have your charge the levels maxed out. Yeah, perfect movement speed. Casting speed is 203%. For this kind of a build, this casting speed is perfect. You don't really need more casting speed for this build. Yeah, so very easy, very fun, very satisfying build to play with, very simple build. It is one of the builds that are very good for people that don't like having many skills, active skills, and they don't like clicking all the time different hotkeys to use many skills. So it is quite simple. You don't even have to use these skills here down here most of the time. Phantom Strike. Let's see. Stun them and kill them. Of course, you cannot stun bosses. You cannot crowd control bosses in general. Maybe there are a couple of exceptions of bosses that can be stunned, but these are very, you know, very rare exceptions. Arachnos drone, whatever. Let's see, where is the boss? There is a boss here, the spider. At Phantom Strike, at down it goes tonight. So yeah, we deal good amounts of physical damage and very good amounts of elemental damage. So these are the powers, the types of damage of this build. Physical and elemental. Odysseus hero deals physical and elemental damage. Now we know. Because in the books they never told us what types of damage could Odysseus do. Back in the day, when he was young and powerful. Well, now we know. He did physical and elemental damage. And here we are, let's sell a couple of items. To farmers, but since the monsters, it's been swords and shields, nice item. Spears. Falcon cape, pants, headdress, I don't need this one. Okay, so this is it guys for this build. Odysseus build, one of the hero builds, heroic builds I have made. I have more builds coming up which are based around very well-known heroes of mythology and history, because Odysseus and everything, all these things are history. Mythology is history, actually. Told in a more fancy way, you could say. But anyway, this is Odysseus' build. The build is very awesome. I will live stream this build sometimes. Maybe soon enough, because I like it and it feels very awesome playing with. And I got to take it throughout the whole legendary difficulty, of course, included the new Act of Eternal Labors. So, guys, thanks for watching this video. I'll be back very, very soon with many more videos and, of course, live streams of Titan Quest and other games as well. So, if you like what you see, click the like button to support the channel. Subscribe to stay tuned with much more content. And of course, leave comments below and say whatever you want to say about the game or in general. I don't know. And I will see you very, 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 very soon again. Have a great one.